Welcome to the University of the Netherlands lecture series by Rolf Hutt. This lecture is about how to recognize different musical pieces using mathematical tricks. The original lecture was done in Dutch. This is the dubbed English version, so I apologize for any lip syncing issues. I also didn't dub the intro, which you will hear in a few seconds. Don't step away, after it we'll go in English. Here we go!
Hoe kun je met behulp van wiskunde de vijfde symfonie van Beethoven herkennen? Dit is de Universiteit van Nederland.
Dankjewel. Everything vibrates. And that's not some new age stuff that I believe in. It's just really true. Because water vibrates, but air vibrates as well. So if the air pressure changes slowly, we're talking about weather, depression will hit us. The air pressure will rise a little bit tomorrow. But if air pressure changes fast, say 20,000 times a second, we're talking about sound. But if you have a microphone, you don't want to measure the weather. Well, it's nice to know, but it's not the prime goal of a microphone. And the other side, if you have a barometer, you don't want to have the noise from the neighborhood influence your measurement. And here I have a nice example of how things can go wrong. And I just put it on my phone. What I did is I played some music on a loudspeaker and I put a microphone in front of it, and I had that microphone record about 1,000 times a second. Only 1,000 times a second. And that sounds like this.
Dit was wat je dan meet.
This is what you measure.
Hè, dus je speelt het ene af. Je zet een microfoon voor je box die maar 100 keer per seconde meet. En als je het dan afspeelt, hoor je dit.
That's kind of weird. It's not the music I was playing. So you want to be able to separate those different waves. So if I have a signal, a measuring signal, well, let's get back to the blackboard. For example, I measure pressure as a function of time. And there's also the weather, which is this very slowly varying, and I've got this music, which is quickly varying, maybe even using the same amplitude. Then what I'll be measuring is the combined effect of these two. Wouldn't it be nice if we could separate this purple signal that I measure into the two waves that constitute it, so that we can actually see what frequencies are present? So there was a Frenchman, Fourier, and he came up with a mathematical trick. This is Fourier. If we didn't have Fourier, by the way, we probably wouldn't have deciphered hieroglyphs. And that is because of a carbon copy, like really carbon copy, not an email. So piece of paper. When Fourier was working for friends in Egypt to steal things, that was what they call archaeology back then, he just put the paper to the Rosetta Stone and made a carbon copy with a pencil, took it back home, and he gave it to one of his protégés, Jean Polier, I probably pronounced it wrong. And he saw that on when he was 11 years old, and he thought, I can decipher that. And it took him years, but he did it. So without Fourier, we wouldn't have deciphered hieroglyphs. But that's not what we're used Fourier for today. Another idea of him was the mathematical trick to get this purple signal and translate it into the underlying waves. And then you can show it as a function of frequency instead of time. And then you put the amplitude of the waves here. So this purple signal is built up of a very long wave with this amplitude. And so it has this wavelength. Something with a long wavelength will vibrate only slowly, so not a lot of vibrations per second. So it has a very low frequency. So wavelength and frequency, there's a reciprocal relation. So at this low frequency, we have a measurement. So we have a wave with this amplitude. At the same time, we also have this wave with a much higher frequency. You see my drawing skills on Blackboard are not on par anyway. So here we see a lot of wavelength, so the frequency is a lot higher, but the amplitude is a bit lower, so we could draw it like that. And now this has the same information as the original signal. So with the Fourier analysis, and that is a basic piece of mathematics that we teach first year undergrads. So if you want to use it, you can do two things. You can study with us in Delft, University of Technology, or you can go to Wikipedia and you can just download ready-made code to apply it without understanding it. I would suggest the first, of course. And that allows you to separate a signal that is made up of different waves into the waves that constitute it. And I just, there was just a piece of music that you listened to, and I'll let you listen to it again. Someone in the audience already said what it was.
Nice.
This. Star Wars Imperial March. I picked this with a reason, of course. It's on the same list as Lego in my previous lecture. Secondly, it has nice high and nice low frequencies in it. Because if you measure the Imperial March, and I mean just the vibrations, then it would look like this. This is just pressure that the Imperial March is. There's not a lot of people that can look at this and that can say, oh, that's the Imperial March, you're Rain Man, maybe. If you can do that, by the way, there's a very lucrative job offers. But using a Fourier analysis, you could look at what the frequencies are that are present in this. And that looks something like this. And you can see at this frequency axis at the bottom, at around 100 hertz, 10 to the power 2, there's a lot of energy. So there's a lot of amplitudes, high amplitudes, around 100 hertz. Those are probably those drums. So this already shows you a little bit more. But so the fun thing is, I have this in my computer right now, so I can play around with it. So what I did is, what if I only take the frequencies below 1000 hertz and I play it?
Hoe klinkt dat dan? Nou zo.
So, music and music aficionados
and music liefhebbers,
they will hear
niet per se hetzelfde te zijn. Die
the different
verschillende instrumenten hierin terug.
I've also done the exact opposite.
Ik heb natuurlijk ook.
So I took all the frequencies.
Precies omgekeerd.
Above 1000 hertz.
Dit zijn alleen de hoge frequenties.
So for the audience in Club Air, I have to now crank it up a little bit.
Het feit dat je nu bijna niks meer hoort.
That is because Club Air invested a lot of money
in lage frequenties goed hoorbaar maken.
Low frequencies audible all over the square outside as well.
Wat nou het aardige is.
With a Fourier analysis, I can take a pressure signal in time and separate it in different frequencies. And I can play the low frequencies, I can play the high frequencies. And the interesting question, if I bring it together again, do I have my original signal back? So this is on the left speakers, I'll put the low frequencies. On the right loudspeakers, I'll put the high frequencies.
En En dan is het, behalve voor mensen die heel goed
only people verschillende that are really good
kunnen horen,
in hearing directions,
hebben we praktisch hetzelfde geluid over.
You get your original sound
voor
back.
Voor mensen die geen richting kunnen horen, hebben we precies hetzelfde geluid over.
So, I'm kind of working on your subconscious here by repeating it over and over again. If you walk home, then you'll be humming this continuously. I'm sorry. So this is great. You can play around with this. Because what I want is that I not only separate these frequencies, because there's frequencies I'm interested in and there's frequencies I'm not interested in. So couldn't I... for example, amplify the high frequencies before I send it to my box and play down the low frequencies. And if you look in iTunes or in another program to an equalizer, then you see all those bars. That's exactly what's going on. That's the Fourier transform in action. And then an equalizer isn't two bands, but multiple bands, low, a little bit higher, mid, high, stuff like that. So the numbers below that are the frequencies that correspond with that. And then you can, if you want to, you can turn the bass up and tune down the treble, and then you're listening to, I don't know, techno. It's kind of what I listen to. So that's nice to play with. That means that you could filter out any frequencies you're not interested in. I started promising that we could use this to recognize music. I've showed you the spectrum of the Imperial March. That's what we call a frequency representation, a spectrum. And I told you that anyone that can tell by a pressure signal in time what it is probably Rain Man. The same thing is basically true for spectra. If you look at that spectra and you could say that is the Imperial March, that's weird. Because a piece of music doesn't have continuously only bass or only high frequencies. So the spectra itself changes in time. You got low when a drum is hit, and you got high when you get a flute. So what you really would want to do is to take the Fourier analysis on a very small piece of sound. It's hard, but you can do it. So you take a very small sample of sound, you take the Fourier analysis of it, and you show it as a color bar. And then you do the same thing for the next piece of sound. And that would look like this. And what you can see here is, so there's some high tones, and then a very long low tone. What you also see is the harmonics that are in this sound. So around 100 hertz, there's a harmonic. And you can see that exact same harmonic at 200, 400, and 800 hertz. That's a property of classical musical instruments. They have this ground tone and those higher harmonics. So you see that tone, it's repeated a few times, and then there's that very long lower. So it's da-da-da-da. So if you're really good at this, you can, from images like this, you can recognize it, because this is what it sounds like. So you can see it over there. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I'm not a singer, I'm sorry. So these kind of images, you can see what's happening in the sound. So what kind of music you're listening at. This is kind of what Shazam does. Shazam does more smart stuff on top of this, but this is the basic. So this is much easier to recognize that this is the fifth of Beethoven, where you couldn't do that from the full spectrum. There's also music that just shows like that you cannot recognize what it is. This is just all over the place. I have no idea what this is.
telt niet als muziek.
Yeah, it's not music. Which is weird, by the way, because a lot of 15-year-olds would disagree with me on that. And I've had that same discussion 15 years ago. And as a physicist and as a scientist, I can see a pattern. And then normally I'm able to predict, extrapolate what would happen next. I can in no way imagine what the... I cannot imagine what the kind of music will be, what my grandchild would talk about with my current child. Anyway, with the Fourier analysis, we can separate what the waves are that makes up a measuring signal. So if we measure fast enough, then we can afterwards discard any waves we're not interested. And then at the end, we're at the same point that we were at the end of the previous lecture. Conclusion is, you have to measure it pretty fast. So in my next lecture, I will explain how you could measure slowly and still lose those annoying high frequency waves. And I'll use the same trick as opera singers that destroy wine glasses.